there, son?
I'm here, Dwayne.
Hear the words that I'm saying. She's got to go, Mike.
I know, Dwayne. I'll speak to a lawyer.
Lawyer? Fancy talk. I recommend drowning, Mike. Real men don't use lawyers. Show your boy what it means to be a man. Press her under the surface of the fluids. Mike, please.
Okay. Love the show, Mike.
Thank you, son. Now we call this show Beyond Insemination because it's about what men like to do besides working on the farm. It's about what we were meant to do. Man against nature. I am highly skilled at the art of noodling in a beaver dam. I do not like the animals that consider themselves engineers. I like plant-eating herbivores you can fatten up, give a loving name to, then callously kill and cook like a civilized man. Back to beavers. I once stuck my arm in a dam and four or five of them, an entire family, in fact, of beavers, bit into my arm. Got every last one of them on the grill that night and a couple of new hats. For the record, I also do not like fire ants, as it is unreasonable to have a social structure of a bunch of neutered men acting as slaves for a woman. Outside of a modern city, of course, where it appears to be mandatory. They call them places offices. I will not sit in a cubicle like a veal calf while a woman shouts at me about making personal calls until I die. Caller, you are on the show. To whom am I speaking?
Hey there, Dwayne. The name's Charlie. Hope all's going well with your divorce.
No, amigo. It is, in fact, crappy as crappy could be. As I said, avoid lawyers at all costs. Now continue.
Well, yeah, my best friend died in a combine accident, and he left me a few head of cattle, but I ain't no farmer, so question is, how do I know if a female cow is in heat? They don't talk or nothing, they just move.
Oh, Charlie, that's simple. You have come to the right place, as I am an expert on estrus. What you gotta do is look for behavioral signs such as excessive mooing, but most of all, she will exhibit more vigorous interaction with other females, putting her chin on the rump of another cow.
Yeah, keep going. Tell me about that dirty heifer.
God damn it. You are sitting there with a hot laptop on your sweaty thighs doing an image search for heifers, aren't you? Jesus. I'm tired of you sickos calling up and ruining my otherwise flawless broadcasting flow. This is a civilized show for civilized people, discussing a variety of topics relating and beyond insemination. Why, oh, why does this subject matter attract such a variety of perverts, creeps, and weirdos? It is quite beyond me. Now, don't get me wrong, I mean, I like a good time. I've been known to participate in a pheromone party where you do not shave or bathe for 1 week and then partake in moonshine and speed with a group of other like-minded individuals in a hot tub. It is hell on the other side of that party, but it is worth the ride. But that does not mean I find calling up a radio program about royal affairs and pleasuring myself while perusing the heifer section of the information superhighway an acceptable form of behavior. Is that clear? Charlie, you pervert, is that clear?
Yes.
Are we straight, son?
Yes, sir.
Good. Now you take care, you hear?
Thank you, sir.
I am lost for words. Next caller.
Hi there, Dwayne. My name is Susan. I'm calling from Sandy Shores. I really like what you said about how animals have babies and then they abandon them and then they go find another mate. Oh, that just touched me. That made me cry. It reminded me when I left little Mary Sue outside the Up and Adam restaurant. I was tired of all her crying and carrying on anyway. Because I just hooked up with a guy I just met named Francis.
Oh, well, good on you, Susan. Though I am not a fan of names that can apply to a man or a woman, unisexery has neutered our society. No man should be named Francis or Alex or Jamie or, God forbid, Casey. But anyway, I'm so glad we inspired you. That's evolved thinking right there. See, we do believe in evolution in the right situation. For the record, not me, nor no one in my family was ever no monkey. Nor have they been with a monkey, not ever, not even at the zoo, nor pretty much any animal, aside from the usual ones we all practice on. There, that's cleared up. Science and truth can exist together, you see? We can learn a lot from nature. You know how a mama puppy cleans up?
Yeah.